heard anything about like people that keep saying Jumu'ah Mubarakah? It's allowed to say that? Or?
No.
I had today an argument about somebody with somebody, I guess, against this, and he said, no, you don't harm anybody. Why you don't see it?
We won't say it's haram, ya ikhwan, because you need text to say something is haram. You need proof to say something is haram in Islam.
When you say haram, we say bid'ah.
No.
But anybody,
because the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never did it.
Yeah, but it's supposed to be a celebration of our Eid.
I think you guys are confusing, ya ikhwan. Go back to the asl, the origin. طيب. Haram, lahu ma'na, has a meaning. Wal bid'ah, laha ma'na. And bid'ah has a meaning also. Not every laysa kulla haramin bid'atan. Not everything that's haram is a bid'ah. Drinking is haram. It's not a bid'ah. It's haram.
Right.
And every bid'ah is haram. But not every haram is a bid'ah. Bid'ah shay'un makhsusun. Bid'ah is something specific.
Ibtada.
Hey, ibtada'a fi?
Fi shay'un. Something that wasn't there and he made it up.
في الدين.
في الدين. That's exactly.
البدعة بدعتان في اللغة وفي الشارع. بدعة can be of two types. In the language and Islamically. في اللغة بمعنى أمر جديد. أمر محدث. In the language, a بدعة means what? Something new.
Yeah.
Linguistically, this laptop is a بدعة. This microphone is a بدعة. This watch is a بدعة. Meaning what? Something new. In the Islam, it means شيءٌ أحدث في الدين لا أصل له أو لا يقام على الدليل. In the Islamically, it means something new in the religion, something that has no origin or is no proof to do it. So it depends.
So now
going back to the word Eid Mubarak, you can't say it's haram.
Yeah.
You can't say it's haram. It can become a bid'ah. It could. If the person, like something we do here a lot in the foreign masajid, where بعد الصلاة الأخ يظن في قلبه عليه أن يسلم على من على يمينه وعلى من على يساره. هو يظن هذا ويفعله بعد كل الصلاة في كل يوم. Where the person, he believes that after every salam, every day, every prayer, he says, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum. Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum. Every salah, not sometimes. Sometimes, that's fine. You didn't see the brother, you turn, hey, Sheikh Ahmed, Salaamu Alaikum. That's different. Every salah, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaamu Alaikum, Salaam. Every salah, every day, there's no proof of that. The Messenger of Allah didn't do that. The companions didn't do that. But generally, salah, generally, it's a bid'ah, something new, something introduced. Has no origin. So now you say, Eid Mubarak. طيب هذا على الجواز. That's allowed. ولكن لا أصل له في هذه الكيفية. But there's no proof to do it like this. That on the Eid, the Prophet said, Eid Mubarak. There's no proof to say that. Omar said, Eid Mubarak. There's no proof. They didn't say that. They would say what on the Eid? They said something on the Eid, but it wasn't Eid Mubarak. Hey, they will say dua. Barakallahu akul aamin wa antu bi khair. Taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum. Every year we hope that you're upon goodness. May Allah accept it from us and you. That's what they will say. That's the sunnah. So Eid Mubarak is allowed. But it's better that you do what? What the Prophet did. What the companions did. For example. You guys with me? When the imam sits down in the Jumu'ah, is it a sunnah that you make a dua? Is it a sunnah? Did the Messenger of Allah do that? Did the Messenger of Allah call for that to be done? When the Imam says, Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, and he sits. You see, many people every Jumu'ah. No. Every Jumu'ah. طيب. أقل شيء هذا على الجواز. The least thing we hope, that's allowed. But you can't say that's a sunnah, ya ikhwan. Illa عندنا دليل. Unless you have some text. When Abu Bakr gave the Jumu'ah, when he stopped, did he say, Allahumma Allah. Did he make dua here? If so, ain't it had al-hadith? Ain't it had al-hadith? Where's that? Where's that proof?
When the imam sit down, those are the moments that the Allah accept duas. Is that proof of that?
Where's the hadith?
I'm just asking.
That's why I'm trying to get myself and my brothers to understand. Before we can say something is a sunnah, قبل أن نتكلم, before we can speak, قبل أن نفعل, before we can do anything, علينا بالعلم, علينا بالدليل. We have to have proof. Now, I'm not saying it's haram. Don't misunderstand my point. I'm not saying it's haram to do that. I'm saying no one can say that anything is a sunnah illa بالدليل, unless he has a proof. There's a hadith that some scholars say is talking about here. Other scholars say la. It's talking about the last hour between the Asr and the Maghrib. When they say it's an hour on the Jumu'ah, whoever is caught in this hour, or as the Messenger of Allah said, making dua, Allah will accept it. Some scholars say here, he's talking about when the Imam sits in Jumu'ah. Other scholars say no, there's another variation of the hadith. It says the last hour of the Jumu'ah, meaning between the day of Jumu'ah, between Asr and before Maghrib comes in. That last hour, Maghrib comes in at 6, for example. 5 o'clock, the last hour before Maghrib. Many scholars say that's the meaning of the hadith. You guys with me, ikhwan? طيب, tonight, inshallah ta'ala, nabda' fi risalatin jadida. So tonight, we're going to start a new small treaty, inshallah. أخذنا عشرة دروس في الفقه. So far we learned, we have 10 classes of fiqh.
معفون, inshallah.
تفضل. الآن سنبدأ إن شاء الله بشيء أهم من ذلك. So tonight, يا إخوان, we're gonna start something a little more honorable than الفقه. استفدنا كثيرا من علم الفقه. We learned a lot. We learned a lot in الفقه. فالآن سنتعلم شيئا أهم من ذلك. وهو علم التوحيد. علم العقيدة. So now we're going to start something a little more honorable than that. The science of belief. The science of التوحيد. وعندنا كتاب صغير جدا الحمد لله من إمامين عظيمين من هذا الدين. And we have a small book that has been explained by two great scholars of Al-Islam. والشرح الذي بين أيدينا شرح شيخنا أبي عبد الله المصنعي حفظ الله تعالى من بلاد اليمن. And the explanation that we're going to read from is one that has been authored by our Sheikh in Al-Yemen, the Sheikh Abu Abdullah Al-Masna'i. And he's explaining the aqeedah of the two imams. فَاكْتُبُوا هَذَا الْعُنْوَانِ يَا إِخْوَانِ. So write down this chapter title. هُوَ عَقِيدَةُ إِمَامَيْنِ الرَّازِيَيْنِ. And this is the aqeedah of the two imams of Al-Razi. The two imams of Al-Razi.
Razi?
No.
Razi is Moroccan, right?
أو قريب من مراكو إما داخلها داخل إما داخلها أو حولها accent. Either it's inside of Morocco or it's on the outskirts. May Allah bless you. Morocco, yeah. The two aqeedah of the two imams of Al-Razi. They're from the town called Al-Razi. Or Raz. No. طيب وفي هذا الكتاب يا إخوان هذان إمامان يذكراني مسائل التي أجمع عليه العلماء. أجمع عليه العلماء. طيب. This book here that we're going to learn, inshallah, is a book that these two imams mention those issues that all of the scholars are unanimous in. All of the scholars are unanimous in. طيب. ومن خصائص هذا الكتاب أحدهما أو أحدهم طيب كلاهما من أئمة هذا الدين وأتاهما ابن أحدهما وهو كذلك من أئمة هذا الدين طيب. So one of the beauties of this book, specifics of this book, is that these two scholars, they both are mountains of knowledge. Abu Hatim and Ubaidullah ibn Abdul Karim. Or Abdul Karim ibn Ubaidullah. طيب. One of them, his son Ibn Abi Hatim, he comes to his father and his father's colleague. And he sits them down and he asks them questions of this religion. فَهَذَا كَيْفَ أَتَانَا هَذَا الْكِتَابِ. And this is how this book has reached us. فَهُوَ يُسَمَّى عَقِيدَةَ الْإِمَامَيْنِ الرَّازِيَيْنِ. And it's called the Aqeedah of the two Imams of Al-Razi. طيب قال بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال أبو طيب قال عبد الرحمن ابن أبي حاتم سألت أبي وأبا زرعة عن مذاهب أهل السنة في أصول الدين. So the student, the child is the one that's asking. He says his name is Abdul Rahman. The book is authored by Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. That's his name. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. You brothers online, write this name down, ikhwan. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. هو الذي كتب هذا الكتاب. Abi Hatim. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. He says what, ikhwan? He says, I asked my father. I asked my father and Abu Zura'a. I asked my father and Abu Zura'a. فعندنا الآن ثلاثة أئمة. So now we have three scholars. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. هو الابن. He's the son. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim. وأبوه أبو حاتم. His father is called Abu Hatim al-Razi. Abu Hatim al-Razi. وأبو زرعة أبو زرعة. The third imam, I want y'all to memorize three names. The third one is Abu زرعة. Abu زرعة. Abu زرعة. Abu زرعة.
This,
this is the, what's the name of the class, Ikhwan?
The first
Imam. At-Tawheed, the subject. Ma Urwan al-Kitab, what's the name of the book? Aqeedah. Imamaini. Al-Raziyin. Ahsan. The Aqeedah of the two Imams. With no notebook, mashallah, may Allah bless him. And all of you. The belief of the two Imams of Al-Razi.
I'm talking about the names. One of them is Abu Zura'a.
Abu Zura'a.
Abu Hatim, right?
Abu Hatim.
Hatim.
And his son.
And his son is number three.
His son is Abdul Rahman.
Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Hatim.
MashaAllah. طيب. The son came to the father and his content, his father's colleague. The son is Abdul Rahman. He went to his father. His father is Abu Hatim.
What's the name?
Oh. First name, the son, Abdul Rahman. Second name is his father. His kunya is Abu Hatim. Ismuhu Muhammad ibn Idris. His name is Muhammad ibn Idris.
Who's that?
The father.
I thought you said the father is Abdul Hatim.
Abu Hatim.
That's his kunya. Abu means father of.
Idris is his second name?
Okay, write this down, Yehwa.
That's the right name, but the kunya.
Okay, the kunya. The kunya, Yehwa. The nickname. Abu
Hatim.
Ummu. That's your nickname, your surname. Your nickname, Afwan. His nickname, his kunya rather, is Abu Hatim.
Yeah.
That's not his name.
Hatim.
So that's
his name. Hatim.
You said Abu Umu.
Muhammad.
His real name is Abu Muhammad what?
Ibn Idris.
Okay, that's the real name.
Ibn Idris.
Muhammad Ibn Idris. You guys with me, Ikhwan? You guys online with me, Ikhwan? The brothers in Chester having some trouble.
You saying that Abu Hatim is Muhammad ibn Idris' nickname? That's the real name.
No. His real name is Muhammad ibn Idris.
That's what I'm saying. Abu Hatim is his nickname.
Yes.
Alright,
I got you now.
What's the son's name?
Abu Rahman.
Son name is
ibn who?
Abu Rahman ibn Abi Hatim.
MashaAllah. طيب, the third name, ya ikhwan. Abu Zura'a. Abu Zura'a. هؤلاء كالجبل يا اخوان في ديننا في العلم الحديث في علم جرح وتعديل في علم الرجال في علم اللغة العربية في علم تفسير. These scholars are scholars of Islam. So I want you to memorize their names. They are scholars of hadith, scholars of praise and criticism, scholars of who's who in the chain of narration. They are some of the ones that brought us the belief of Ahl Sunnah, as you're going to see. The third name, Ya Ikhwan, the third name is who? Abu Zura'a. Zura'a. Abu Zura'a. Abu Zura'a. فما اسمه هو يا اخوان؟ His name is Ubaydullah.
What is his name?
Ubaydullah.
Ubaydullah, that's his name.
So Abdul Zuhra is
his nickname. You guys make it easy, اخوان. You guys, I don't know. Bismillah. Nickname. Tell you, we call Uthman, Abu Tad, Abu Makan, Abu Suq. We call you Abu Suq.
Your real name is
what? That's not your name.
Abu Zuhra, what's his real name?
Ubaydullah, ya
khwan.
طيب. Three names, ya khwan. عندنا ثلاثة أسماء. Three names, ya khwan. طيب. من يكتب لنا أسماء هؤلاء الأئمة. Who can write these names of these scholars' names? Who can write these scholars' names down, ya khwan? From our brothers online. Three names. Al-Ibn. No, close.
Abu Hatim.
Abu Hatim al-Ab. You don't have to memorize the whole name. Either the kunya or the name. Abdurrahman, who is al-Ibn. So I want you to memorize. Abdurrahman is the son. Abuhu Muhammad ibn Idris. His father, Muhammad ibn Idris.
Abu
Hatim. Allahu Akbar. His kunya is Abu Hatim. وثالثه, the third man. عبيد الله ابن عبد الكريم. عبيد الله ابن عبد الكريم. كنيته أبو زرعة. His kunya is أبو زرعة. Three names. عبد الرحمن, محمد ابن إدريس, عبيد الله ابن عبد الكريم. أنتم معي يا إخوان. You guys with me? طيب. So he says, I asked my father. Who's man in mutakallim? Who's speaking? I asked my father.
Abdurrahman.
Abdurrahman. Al-kitabu min hu. Huwa. Who are the kataba? The book is from him, the son.
So I'm going to cut you off. So who is Abdul Zuhra?
Oh. So we'll come back to that, inshallah. One second. Abu Zura'a is Ubaydullah.
Abdul, who is it towards the, now we know it about the father?
His companion, his homeboy.
Okay, so that's
he lives on 8th Street, he lives on 6th Street, they buddies.
So he just buddies with the two father and son.
Two scholars and a son, okay? Three.
Got it.
These are mountains of knowledge, ya Ikhwan. Knowing them may be more honorable than knowing ourselves.
Okay.
Why do we say that? Knowing ourselves, لا يرفعنا شأنا في الإسلام أبدا. Knowing ourselves, it's never going to raise us up in Islam. I know my name. That makes me higher? La. You know your name. That makes you higher? La. You know the imams of the past and what they believed. How can we call ourselves Ahl Sunnah? How can we call ourselves Ahlul Hadith? How can we call ourselves Ahlul Haq? How can we call ourselves Al-Firqatun Najiyah, the saved sect? Wa nahnu najhalu anhum. And we're ignorant of them. How? It's impossible. How can we say I follow the Sunnah and you don't know nothing from the Sunnah? It's impossible. How can you say I follow the Quran وَأَنْتَ جَاهِلٌ عَنِ الْقُرْآنِ when you know nothing from the Quran? It's impossible, ya Ikhwan. It's impossible. How can I say I'm following the companions? Who are they? I follow the Tabi'un. Who are they? Allahu A'lam. I know LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan. That's most of us. How can we say I follow the imams of the past? As-salaf, ahl-sunnah, ahl-hadith, ahl-haq. وَنَحْنُ نَجْحَلُ عَنْهُمْ الْجَوَابُ هَذَا الْمُسْتَحِيلُ. How can I say I follow them if I don't know who they are? The answer is, that's impossible. It's impossible. Someone says, make a right on Main Street. Where's Main? I don't know where Main is. How can I make my right if I don't know where it's at? It's impossible. So we have to know the imams of the past. How can I follow these imams if I don't know who they are, ikhwan? It's impossible. You guys with me? Mm-hmm. So saying you're upon the sunnah, I follow the people of the sunnah. And most of us, it's a claim. It's a za'am. It's a claim. Most of us. For example. And we're trying to make this claim a reality. طيب. فَمَنْ يَذْكُرُ كُلَّهُمْ. Who can mention all of them?
Even,
without looking.
Even the nickname?
Abdul Rahman.
As you wish. Whatever is easy for you.
Muhammad Idris.
Ibn Idris.
Ibn Idris.
Zuhra. Abu Zura'a.
Abu Zura'a.
What's his name? Abu Zura'a, what's his name? Without looking.
Ubaydullah
ibn Abdul Kareem. That's how you rehearse. You ask. He says, I asked my father and Abu Zura'a about the methodology of the people of Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah in the affairs of the religion. انظر إلى فهم هذا الابن. Look at the understanding of this child. أتى إلى أبيه. وإلى شيخ آخر من أصدقاء أبيه. He went to his father, a great scholar, and a companion of his father, another great scholar. Another great scholar. فقال وما أدرك عليه العلماء في جميع الأمصار. And he's asking them about the scholars that they have met from every region of the world. These scholars travel all across the world. True students of knowledge. So the son is asking them about the methodology of the people of the truth, Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah, in the affairs of the religion, and the scholars that you guys met from all various aspects of the world. وَمَا يَعْتَقِدَانِ فِي ذَلِكَ. And what you believe, you two, from everything that you heard from these various scholars. قَالَ. So they said. They said. Who was the they? Ubaid Allah. Allahu Akbar. Qala adrakna al-ulama'a fi jami' al-amsari. So they says, we have met various scholars from all regions of the world. Hijazan, from Hijaz. Iraqan, and Iraq. Wa Yamanan, and Yemen. Wa Shaman, and Syria. Fakana min madhabihim. And from their methodology was the following. This is important. It's tremendous. هؤلاء العلماء أخذ عن كثيرا من علماء جميع الأمصار من إيراق ومن يمن من مصر من إفريقيا من شام من جميع أنحاء الأرض. These great scholars took knowledge from various scholars from all over the world, from Yemen, from Iraq, from Africa, from Egypt, from Sham. And الآن يبينوا اعتقاد هؤلاء. And they're going to clarify the belief of these other great imams. The belief of the people of the Sunnah. So they say, الإيمان قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. أول شيء يا أخوان يكتب عندنا في هذه الليلة. The first thing I want you to write is, they said, Iman is speech and actions. Iman is speech and actions. Iman is speech and actions. وَيَزِيدُ وَيَنْقُصُ. It increases and decreases. It increases and decreases. الأمر الأول, point number one. أهم من أسماء هؤلاء. More important than the names of these great scholars. Point number one. الإيمان قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. Iman is speech and actions. It increases and decreases. طيب.
Faith.
تفضل.
Brother, maybe you can understand Iman.
Hey, accent. Meta Jamtu.
Yeah.
The brother said you didn't translate that word. Iman is faith. Is faith. Your belief. Iman. One brother said that, so I try to translate everything. He said, aqeedah jumu'ah, there was a word you didn't translate. I said, alhamdulillah, I'm human, ya ikhwan. May Allah bless you. Iman, faith, is what? Man yukammil, who can complete?
Can
finish.
Increase and decrease.
Iman.
No, it's action.
It's speech and action.
Hey, qawlun.
Increase
and decrease. Allahu Akbar. Tfadha. Iman.
But your speech.
Iman is speech. It's speech and action.
Huh?
It's decrease.
Increases?
Increase and decrease.
Tfadha. Yes, sir.
I need to know.
You know everything.
This man traveled tonight. He not like his normal self. So he traveled.
Repeat what we said.
Father, Iman is what?
He's asking what is Iman. What he
increase
see.
And decrease.
Mm.
No.
Iman
is
increase
and decrease.
Iman increase and decrease.
That's hadaf shayun akhar. That's something different. Yeah,
I'm stupid.
Father.
Iman is speech and action.
It's
increases and decreases.
Allahu Akbar. فالآن هذان إمامان يبينان لنا أن هذا الأمر من أصول الدين. So now these two imams are clarifying for us that this one point, iman is speech, action, it increases and decreases, is from the principles of this religion. فالذي يخالف أن الإيمان قول أو عمل ولا يزيد ولا ينقص هو يخالف أمرا من أموري usuli ad-din. So anyone who opposes that iman is speech and actions, it increases and decreases, he's opposing something from the principles of this religion. فهذا الأمر الأول. That's point number one. قال والقرآن كلام الله غير مخلوق. He says, and they also said, the Qur'an is the speech of Allah. It is not created. And the Qur'an is the speech of Allah. غَيْرُ مَخْلُوقٍ مِنْ جَمِيعِ جِهَاتِهِ From all of its angles, from every angle that you come with regarding the Qur'an, is not created. And the Qur'an is the speech of Allah. Is not created. بِجَمِيعِ جِهَاتٍ With all of his, any angle you come with, if it's from Qur'an, or if it's the Qur'an, is not created. What's point number one?
Iman.
The Qur'an is...
Point number one?
Iman is...
Allahu Akbar.
And
Allahu Akbar. Point number two?
Qur'an is not created.
Oh.
It's the speech of Allah.
Opposite. Qur'an is the speech of Allah.
It
is not created.
Tayyib.
Guys with me, ikhwan. Qala wal qadru khayruhu wa sharruhu min Allah azza wa jal. Point number three. And then we'll explain. Point number three. And the qadr, it's good and it's evil, are from Allah. The qadr, the divine decree, it's good and it's bad. It's from Allah. Al-qadru khayruhu wa sharruhu min Allah. The qadr, the divine decree, it's good and it's bad. If I can say that, if that's a suitable translation, it's from Allah. It's from Allah. Tayyib. هذا مفهوم يا إخوان. You guys understand that? طيب قال اعتقاد. He says the word belief. The word belief. What does the word belief mean? قال اعتقاد القلب المتيقن بوجود الله تعالى وحدانيته وخبره ورسله واليوم الآخر. So he says here, belief is the belief of the heart, that which is of certainty, the certain belief that a person has in his heart with regards to the existence of Allah, to the existence of Allah and his oneness and وَخَبِرِهِ and that you believe and what Allah mentions. The information from Allah and His messengers and the last day. And the last day. قَالَ وَيَشْمَلُ ثَلَاثَةَ أُمُورٍ And this encompasses three things. Three things. قَالَ الْأَوَّلُ مَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِاللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى وَبِعِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ Point number one. When you say belief, it encompasses three things. The first thing is that it is talking about what is connected to Allah. That's why belief is so important. You're talking about مَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِاللَّهِ What is connected to Allah. Ta'ala. وَبِعِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ And what is connected to knowledge of the unseen. Knowledge of the unseen. This is the first point. That is connected. Belief is what? It encompasses three things. You're talking about three things. Every time you say belief. Every time you say aqeedah. You're talking about three things. Number one. Everything that's connected to Allah. And the knowledge of the unseen. Knowledge of the unseen. And knowledge of the unseen. There's some things that Allah doesn't allow us to see in this life. Ilm al-ghayb. Things that are unseen. They're hidden from Bani Adam. From mankind. Can't see them.
What you mean by knowledge of the unseen? You mean believing on the unseen or knowledge of the unseen?
The iman is consistent of having belief
to the unseen.
Of the unseen.
So why do you say knowledge of the unseen?
Or you can say knowledge or belief. You're talking about belief here. Right. So you have to have knowledge from belief is having knowledge of the unseen. Right. If somebody says, I believe in Allah, but I don't believe that this name is from the names of Allah. And that name is Thabit. أَنَّهُ مِنْ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ فَإِمَانُهُ نَاقِسٌ The person says, I believe in Allah. But this name right here, I don't believe that this is a name of Allah. But it really is. It really is a name of Allah. He just doesn't accept it. You show him, this is from the Quran and Sunnah. Allah said it. The Messenger of Allah said it. He says, for example, مثلاً, for example, أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَيْسَ فَوْقٌ He says, I don't believe Allah is above. He says, I don't believe Allah is above. طيب, أولاً, أريه الدليل. Firstly, show him the proof in the Quran. لابد من تبيين. لابد من إظهار الدليل. You have to show the person the proof or tell them where they can go. Islam is not built upon opinions. الإسلام يبنى على أدلة. Islam is built upon proofs. Don't be afraid to ask somebody for proofs, يا إخوان. لا تستحيوا أن تسألوا عن أدلة أبدا. Don't ever be shy to say عفوا يا شيخ عفوا يا أخي may Allah bless you. Where's your proof of that? If he's on the Sunnah, he's going to love you more. I guarantee you. If he's on the Sunnah, إذا يكون على سنة النبي سيحبك أكثر. If he's on the Sunnah, he's never going to get offended that you ask him for proofs. If he's truly on the Sunnah, I guarantee you, he's going to love you more. لأنه الآن يعلم أنك لا تقلده. Because now he knows you don't blind follow him. He's going to love you more. You're not a blind follower. You come and sit right here, يا أخي. You're my homeboy. We're going to be besties. Because you're not a blind follower. Whatever I say, you're not going to take my word because I was on the minbar. La la. Because I had the microphone. La la la. Because I have a thobe. I go to masjid such and such. I have a beard. Blah. None of that gives you the right to blind follow someone, ya ikhwan. Al-taqlidu haram. Blind following is haram. You guys with me? Ma uridukum an taqulu. What do I want you to say now? So you're paying attention. Who's sleep like Uthman? Oh. I said blind following is haram. What did I just teach you?
You.
So what I want you to say?
Ask, what's the proof?
Ask me my proof.
In the Quran.
I got a question. Mm. If you tell somebody...
Which man is Allah. I sent you, Akhi, may Allah bless you. That was from me. I didn't give no proof, ya Khwan.
Yeah.
I just mentioned, don't be afraid. That was a trick question to see who's paying attention. Yeah. My brother was paying attention. You understand? I said what? What did I say?
A black follow.
What did I say after that?
Black follow is haram.
Ah, Allahu Akbar. That's from me. Tayyip. So I wanted you to say what? Where's my proof of that? You guys with me? Even myself, don't be afraid. I'm teaching you to ask even me. If you're going to do it with me, you're going to do it. I hope you do it with everyone. Inshallah. You guys with me? Fadlan.
Is it permissible, I don't know how else to put it, but I'm just saying blind follow. If it comes to, if it's in regards to like a highly respected scholar, or is it still haram all across the board?
But the brother's asking, what about if it's from a particular scholar, a great sheikh? Do we blind follow then? And I'm going to raise my voice now. At-taqleedu haram. Blind following is haram. Accent. Blind following is haram. Mahma kana min unas. No matter who the person is. Nuhibbul ulama. We love the scholars. So? Umiruna an nuhibbahum. We've been commanded to what? Love the scholars. Hadha min amrillah wa amri an-nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Tayyib. Walakin nuhibbuhum hubban shar'iyyan. Uktubu hadha. Write this down, ya ikhwan. We love the scholars. We love them. We've been commanded to love them. But we love them with a legislative love. Not a homeboy love. Not a from the streets love. Not a project love. Not a went to high school together love. Not we play basketball together love. Not I almost got jumped and a brother came down from my, not like that. Not Islamically. We love them Islamically. And this is something that we're not doing now. خاصةً في أمريكا, especially in America. طيب, فدليلي على أن التقليد حرام, my proof that التقليد is حرام, سورة الأعراف. سورة الأعراف. Allah Ta'ala says in سورة الأعراف, طيب, Allah Ta'ala says, اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم, ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون. Allah Ta'ala says, follow what has been sent down to you from your Lord. Allahu Akbar. And do not follow other than that, taking it as a awliya, as friends, guardians, protectors, besides Allah. How little do they ponder? Ma huwa shahid? What's the point here? Hadha amrun min Allah. This is a commandment from Allah. Ta'allamna qabla usbu' usbu'ain amran azeeman min usuli al-fiqh. We learned a week ago, 2 weeks ago or so, a tremendous point from the principles of usul al-fiqh. What was this point, ya ikhwan? Something about a commandment. Who went over their notes? Huh?
Last week
or a week before last?
Yeah, he did a question about commandments.
Something about a commandment. Oh, see who paid attention.
It's obligatory.
Hey, the commandment shows that the thing that comes after it is obligatory. So Allah commanding us what? To follow the book of what has been sent down from your Lord. Meaning what? The Quran and the Sunnah. So it's obligatory that you follow what? The Quran and the Sunnah. You give me any sheikh. I love the scholars. That's from Islam. It's from Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah. Min Ahlul Al-Haq. Min Ahlul Hadith. Hubbun lil-ulama. That you love the scholars. طيب. أنت أتيت الآن وتعطيني كلام من أي شيخ ما من أي زمان ما بعد النبي بعد النبي لا يجب علي أن أخذه شرعا. You give me any scholar you wish. You choose the time period. You choose. Today's time. Ash-Shawkaanee's time. Before that, me. After that, Sheikh Ibn Abbas. Before that, Ash-Shawkaanee. Before that, who ya ikhwan? An-Nawawi. Before that, Imam Ahmed. Before that, Abu Hanifa. Before that, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. You guys with me? You give me any one of their speech that you wish, any scholar you wish, with no proof behind it, no hadith, no verse, you can't make me take it. I can take it. But is it yajibu, mujbiran, wajiban alayya? Al-jawabu la. Is it obligatory? Am I forced to take it? You come and say, your own sheikh, one of your scholars in Yemen, Sheikh Muhammad Imam, may Allah preserve the Sheikh. Sheikh Yahya, may Allah preserve the Sheikh. Who was it? Sheikh al-Wasabi, Sheikh al-Masnaee, whose words we're reading tonight, who's still alive today. Alhamdulillah. I'm trying to give him the right introduction for a book I translated. We'll see, inshallah, if he agrees. Tayyip. They say, the brother says, your own Sheikh says. I'm saying, Tayyip. Do I have to follow that? Do I have to follow this Sheikh that I learned from? Or this Sheikh that I learned from? Or this Sheikh that I never met? Do I have to follow him with no proof from Quran and Sunnah? The answer is no. As one brother said, you don't blind follow Sheikh such and such? I said, no. Blind following is haram. I said, you know who taught me that? The Sheikh that you said I got to blind follow. One brother said, you don't blind follow Sheikh Rabir? I said, no, I love Sheikh Rabir. He's a great scholar of hadith from Mecca. We love the Sheikh. We love him. But you know who told me blind follow is haram? Him. When he quoted sometime, Ibn Taymiyyah said, Ibn Qayyim said, and he quoted another Sheikh, and he said, but I don't agree with that. He said, I don't blind follow him. He said, he didn't blind follow him. So why do I have to blind follow him? Blind following is haram. But us nowadays, a brother comes and say, Sheikh such and such said, Alhamdulillah. Give me the verse. Give me the Quran. Give me the hadith. You stopping at this Sheikh said and this Sheikh said, that's never going to end. Last week we talked about reciting the Quran. We mentioned four opinions from four different imams. Who remembers? Reciting Al-Fatiha. Is it obligatory upon everyone? Upon the imam only? Is Fatiha obligatory at all? We mentioned more than two opinions.
Three opinions.
More than three opinions. But at any rate, opinions. The first opinion is what? Everyone recites Al-Fatiha. The imam and those being led. Who said that? Imam Ahmed. It helps you a lot, ya ikhwan, when you learn who said it. It's not a proof. But it helps you a lot. Tayyip, we also learned that Al-Fatiha is not obligatory at all. It's the weakest. But what's obligatory is that you recite whatever is easy for you to recite from the Quran. Who said that? Abu Hanifa. It's not a proof. It's the weakest opinion. It's a proof to it. But it's not the meaning of Al-Fatiha. We also learned another opinion. We learned three. No, we mentioned three. Tayyip. That Al-Fatiha is only obligatory upon the imam. Not upon those who are being led in the salah. Man qala hadha. Who said that? Ash-Shafi agrees with Imam Ahmed. The one that's left. Imam Malik. Of our time, who has that opinion of today? One of the scholars that we mentioned the most. That you're not going to go to a masjid on the Sunnah in America, except that they're going to say, this hadith was graded authentic by Imam Albani. He agrees with Imam Malik. That what? Al-Fatiha is obligatory only upon the Imam. Tayyip. Ain't a dalil. Where's the proofs? My point is what? Imam Ahmed didn't blind follow Abu Hanifa. Ash-Shafi didn't blind follow Imam Malik. Imam Malik didn't blind follow. No, they didn't blind follow each other, ikhwan. You have to look at the proofs. And Imam Ahmed used to say, Qulu Malik wa Shafi'i wa Sufyan ilayya sawa. Allahu Akbar. Khudu min haythu akhadu. Imam Ahmed used to say a tremendous point. Memorize this point if you wish, ikhwan. He would say, the statement of Malik, the statement of a Shafi'i, the statement of Sufyan, the statement of al-Awza'i, to me, is all the same. Allah, a true imam, not like us. Sheikh such and such said it, oh, you gotta do it. It's not like that, ikhwan. Look at these great imams. The statement of Malik, the statement of Shafi'i, the statement of Sufyan al-Thawri, the statement of al-Awza'i, to me, is the same. Meaning what? Opinions. He said, but rather, khudu min haythu akhadu. He said, but rather take from where they took from. Meaning what? The book of Allah and the Sunnah. It's something that we forgot. You bring me any sheikh, I'm going to say to you what? Hati dalil. Give me a proof. And this is something that our beloved brothers, we love the brothers, we're not doing. Now we're using the scholars as our proofs. And we'll stop with this last statement by our Sheikh, Sheikh Salim Al-Tawil from Kuwait. He used to say, أنت أتيتني بقول الألباني وأنا أتيتك بقول ابن عباس أين الأصل. He says, you're coming to me with, Sheikh Albani said. They were talking about the issue of fiqh. He said, I'm giving you, Ibn Abbas said. They were talking about raising your voice after the salah. Do you make your dhikr to yourself or do you raise your voice? You ever heard that issue before? Do you say it to yourself or can you raise your voice?
To yourself.
To yourself? You raise your voice. Toyib. The Sheikh said, give me a proof. He said, there's a statement by Ibn Abbas. The hadith is in Bukhari Muslim. Ibn Abbas says, we used to know the hadith, the salah was over by the sounds of the people making their dhikr. Subhanallah, subhanallah, akbar Allah, la ilaha illallah. Not in unison, but he used to hear their sound. He said, that's how we knew the prayer was over. So he's saying, the origin is what? After salah, you can raise your voice and make your dhikr. The brother said, Sheikh Albani said, he said, this issue is never going to end. I'm giving you Ibn Abbas, you give me Sheikh Albani. You give me Ahmed, I give you Shafi. You give me Malik, I give you Abu Hanifa. You give me Shawkani, I give you Nawawi. You give me Ibn Taymiyyah, I give you Ibn Qayyim. It never ends, like today. Sheikh Fozan says, Sheikh Rabi says. Sheikh Rabi says, Sheikh said, it never ends. Give me the origin. Call Allah, call Nabi.
The other Indian brothers, they said that this, I heard that from the Indians, they said, they do a lot that they can tell the prayers end by the prophets.
By the dhikr.
The dhikr. Mm. So what they do is now they say, Assalamu alaikum, you hear them say, Allahu akbar, it's not making a dhikr. Is that accurate?
Alhamdulillah. The first thing the prophet will do after the salah is what? A dhikr.
No, but what I'm trying to say is, the moment they give salam, the first word they say is Allahu Akbar.
I agree that's with him, I read the hadith.
That's a dhikr.
He said aloudly one time, Allahu Akbar.
Alhamdulillah. It's not mentioned how many times you have to say it, Ikhwan. The order that you say it. If you say Astaghfirullah, you made your dhikr. If you say it three times, that's the sunnah. Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Can I say it five times?
But the point is the way.
You understand? The prophet said it three. Is it allowed to say it five?
No, because that's something new. Yeah, you can.
It's allowed, yeah, Ikhwan. It's allowed. The prophet used to pray two raka'ah before the fajr. He didn't do what? He would lay down on his side. On his right side. Is it allowed to lay on my left side?
Okay, yes.
It's allowed. That's why it's so important to know the rulings of these issues. Is it allowed for me to do some reading? You come in the they didn't call the van yet. I pray my two raka'ah. Do I have to lay down? Is it obligatory? You don't have to. It's a sunnah. Can I lay down slightly and then get up and pray again? Okay. Can I read some Quran? You guys with me?
Yes.
Can I go over some hadith?
Yes.
Yeah, it's a sunnah. Not every sunnah is obligatory. You guys with me? So now this brother, according to Uthman, he says, Assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar is a dhikr. You can do that. Subhanallah. Astaghfirullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Allahu la ilaha illahu al-hayyul qayyum. Oh, that's dhikr, ya khwan. That's why it's so important for us to learn. Many of the issues that we're arguing, number one, we're ignorant of them. You ask the brother, where did you get that from? What's the origin? Anytime you have an issue, ask yourself, ma huwa al-asl? What's the origin? You're backbiting brother such and such. Tell you, what's the origin of backbiting? Allowed or haram? The origin? Haram. There's certain times you can backbite. Tell you, before that, what's the origin? It's haram. It stops all your issues now. Tell you, lying. Whatever your issue is. Ma huwa al-asl fil kadhib. What's the origin of lying? Can you lie originally? It's haram. Sometimes lying is not haram. It's still a lie. You're going into a town, they're trying to cause you some trouble. This is my blood brother, Kareem, my blood brother. And he's also my Muslim brother. He accepted Islam. They are against me, this town. I come to Chester, Chester's against me. Well, I won't say that. Some parts of Chester. I'll say that. Tell you. My brother's with me. They're against me. They want to cause harm to me and my family. They say, who is with you? Who is this guy with you? Oh, that's my Muslim brother. I didn't lie. Right? I did tadlis. And Arabic tadlis is called what? Akhul kadhib. The lying of brother. Or the brother of lying.
But I can totally lie even hiding identity just to protect you.
Is it still a lie though?
Which allow.
Is it still a lie? Answer my question. Is it still a lie?
Yeah.
The answer is yes. But you're not held accountable. Two different things. Lying is always lying. But there's sometimes it was allowed for you to lie. But did I lie? Yes. But it's not haram here. Like what Ibrahim did.
Hey,
when he was traveling with his wife, that's the point. They were trying to harm him. Who is with you? He said, my sister. He didn't lie. He did tadlis. Tadlis is when you say something, giving the impression that is one way, you don't intend it to be that. In the time of the imams, they were torturing people, harming people, killing people, putting them in jail. If you did not believe, the Quran was created. So many imams would say what? They would say, Tayyib, huwa makhluq. Huwa makhluq. They would say, okay, it's created. And they would raise their finger. It's. The man is thinking you're talking about the Quran. They're talking about their finger. That's called the brother of lying. They're not lying. They say it's. What's the it? He's talking about his finger. They think he's talking about the Quran. You guys with me? Someone comes in here and says, hey, you seen Naeem? And I go like this. Allahu Akbar, he was just right there. I didn't lie. Man, I didn't lie. I didn't lie. I was just sitting right there. That's called tadlis. The brother of lying. It's not a lie. Two brothers are arguing. You say, mashallah, yaki, calm down, bismillah. I just heard the brother making dua for you. He says, you heard that? Allahu Akbar. He made dua for me? Yes. I heard him. The brother leaves. The brother does come and say, hey, you heard him making dua? He said, yeah. He said, what did he say? He said, oh Allah, I ask that you bring peace upon every servant of yours. Tashahud. He's a servant of Allah. So he made dua for him too. You understand? He didn't say his name specifically, but generally. So we'll stop there, ikhwan, as we pass our time. فاليوم قرأنا بداية الكتاب آخر في علم العقيدة. So tonight we read the beginning of another book, ikhwan, in the science of aqeedah. The book Aqeedah to Imamain al-Raziyain. The book of the aqeedah of the two imams of al-Razi. ونواصل إن شاء الله تعالى فيما بعد في هذا الكتاب حتى ننتهي به. And we'll continue إن شاء الله تعالى until we finish this book. For our brothers online, we'll stop there. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. آمين وإياكم.